Hi, good afternoon, everyone. Pretty much the last session of the day, and I know I've been leading workshops for last, at least would have led more than 50 workshops in last 1 year. So I know especially the lunch after session, you know, how do they go. So what I will try to do my best is to keep it as much as engaging so that your attention is, you know, more on the participation in terms of the insights you can derive from the session. Just a big background about myself. My name is Pradeep Chopra. I started using digital marketing way back in 2000 when we had started our first business. And how it happened was, we launched a business and we wanted to sell a product which was into IT education. And 2000, there was nothing else we knew rather than, you know, just going to various institutes to sell that product. So my partner must have visited around more than 150 institutes in Delhi to sell that product. Could not sell even one copy. And by chance, I was online. I was trying various things. And suddenly, while we were sleeping, because someone bought the product from US at 5 times the price, we were trying to sell here in India. And that happened through search engine optimization. And that was in 2000 when the terms, and you know, it was not so even clear even to us. So since then, I have been a digital marketing personal as a practitioner. We were among the first few people who used SEO when it was here in this part of the country. Then when PPC came in, we started using that. And when social media came in, we were doing that. And I've been still using that for our another business. 2010 January, we launched Digital Vidya, which is essentially a digital marketing learning organization. And we enable individuals and organizations leverage digital marketing for their organization to fulfill various business objectives. And within digital marketing, given social media is right now, you know, among the hottest topics. So largely the work we are doing is in the domain of social media. Last 15 months, we would have done over 50 workshops in India and Singapore, including for a lot of corporates, Cisco, Wipro, and largely they have been social media or, you know, with a flavor of other forms of digital marketing. So what, of course, today's session is not about social media. However, there is a one common connect between PPC advertising and social media that I will share in depth again as well. And as I shared, my session is going to be, you know, I would want you to participate so that it becomes engaging and you derive maximum value. So let me start by asking, how many of you have run a PPC campaign? Cool. And I know some of you, they have been doing for a long time. So you would know much more than what I know, or at least there would be a lot of areas where you would know much more than I. So I would invite you to, you know, share from your experience so that together we can make it, you know, even more interesting. And how many of you have, you know, no idea what is PPC? Is there anyone who doesn't know? Or let me start by, why is it called PPC? It's pay-per-click, right? So if you see how this whole model of PPC came in or revolutionized the whole digital advertising space was, prior to, it was first, I think, Overture. Then, you know, Google came in much later. But prior to the PPC, which is a pay-per-click advertising model, it was largely display advertising in the form of impressions. So ads were largely sold as number of impressions. And the model which is still there is called CPM. That is cost per 1,000 impressions. That means your ad is, shown once it's, there are 1,000 impressions. Out of every 1,000 impressions, you will pay to the publisher, independent of whether someone has clicked on an ad or not. When Google, and then before that, Overture came in with a model of you pay only when someone clicks on your ad. You know, that made it much more performance oriented, because people will only click on an ad. You know, largely people will only click on an ad when the ad is of interest. So even if the ad is being shown to people who are not relevant and they don't end up clicking the ad, your money is not going waste. So the whole model of CPC revolutionized the whole concept of digital advertising. And that's why Google is where it is. Even today, majority of Google's revenue come from PPC advertising. And you know, now Facebook is into the same race. Facebook has Facebook advertising. By the way, how many of you have run a Facebook advertising campaign? Okay, some of you have run a Facebook advertising campaign as well. So I'll be sharing a lot about that as well. We've been doing a lot of Facebook advertising. So, where all have you seen paid advertisements in the online world? Like one is, you know, search engines. Where else have you seen paid advertisements in the online world? Facebook is one, sure. One is search engines. Where else have you seen Facebook ads? Sorry, someone said from here? Email, yeah. So if you see Google, through Google AdWords, the ad goes in the email as well. And recently Google announced or shared that the quality of the advertisement in the mails is also going to be much better. They have made some algorithm shift to make it even more relevant. So emails is another very interesting place where you would have seen ads, especially in the Gmail. Where else have you seen ads? Which other platforms have you seen ads in the online world? YouTube, sure. If you see YouTube under a video, there is an ad. And that can also go through Google. So that's, sorry? LinkedIn ads is there. That's again has both PPC and CPM model. Great. Anywhere else you have seen that? Twitter has come up with something called promoted tweets. I'll share about that as well. So Twitter has also, you know, taken on. Cool. So I think most of it is covered. Let me quickly walk you through the all platforms or all the places where a PPC or an advertisement in the online world is being shared today. So all of you, I'm sure that you would understand, like, you know, any search engine where the, especially on Google, the component which is on the top or on the right is a function of Google Ads. The results which are part of the normal search are called because of search engine optimization or called organic SEO, while the top and the right hand side is because of a function of Google AdWords. The program which Google runs, which is a PPC advertising program, is called Google AdWords. Because even today, that is still a majority of online advertising in the CPC format. I'll just quickly walk you through this video, which talks about at a very fundamental level, what is Google AdWords, what all can be done in terms of its capabilities. And if you see, rest of the other platforms follow from that. So there's a lot of commonality. So to give you a brief background about how does Google Ads work, I'll walk you through this video. So that will give you an idea about how does Google Ads work. Can you switch on the audio?
Entering a search query, and you're quickly...
I'll just restart it.
Getting your business to appear on Google is easier than you might think. The first step is learning how Google works. When you use Google, you start by entering a search query, and you're quickly taken to your results page for that query. On the left-hand side of this page are the natural search results, based on a complex automated analysis of how relevant the linked sites are likely to be to your search query. You can't directly influence these results. However, there are also text blocks whose contents you can influence. These sponsored links appear on the right-hand side of your search results page, and on some occasions they also appear on the top. When a Google user does a search that is related to your business, you can make sure that a link to your business appears along with their results for that search. And you can choose when and where that ad for your business appears. And getting started is much easier than you might imagine. First, you need to define the potential customers that you would like to see your ad. You can select their language and location by countries, regions, or cities. If you are a business based in Leeds, for example, you can choose to show your ad only to people based in Yorkshire. Or, if your service is not location specific, your ad can appear to people across the UK. Secondly, write the ad itself as an introduction to your business. The structure of the ad consists of a title, followed by a couple of lines describing your products or services, and finally, your website address. Third, choose which words, when typed into the Google search box, you want to trigger your ad to appear. These are called keywords, and you should choose the words that you imagine your customers would use to find your type of service or business. If you're a florist, for instance, you might want to start your keyword list with flower delivery. The more precise your keywords, the more likely you are to reach people looking for exactly what your business offers. Finally, choose the maximum you want to pay for each click on your ad and the total budget you want to spend each day. One of the best aspects of AdWords is that when someone searches on one of your chosen keywords, and your ad appears on Google, you aren't charged anything. You only pay for your ad when someone clicks on the link through to your website. You're in complete control of every financial aspect of your campaign. How high up the list your sponsored link appears is partly determined by how much you decide you want to pay for each click. However, it is also determined by how relevant your ad is to the search query. Therefore, the more targeted your ad and list of keywords, the less money you will need to spend to ensure your ad appears. Using Google AdWords, you will be advertising your business, but it's nothing like traditional advertising. AdWords is unlike traditional advertising because you choose exactly where and when you want your ads to appear. So only people that are actually searching for what you offer will see them, and you only pay for your ads placement when people actually click on them. You can make changes to your ads whenever you wish and turn your campaigns on and off at your discretion. And since the price you pay is based on an auction, you may start receiving visitors to your website for only a few pence per click. Finally, there is no minimum spend, and you have complete control of your investment. You know how much you have paid for your visitors at all times, and you can change your daily budget as you wish. So appearing on Google is within the reach of anyone. Are you ready to be found on Google? Go to adwords.google.co.uk and create an account today.
So this was about Google UK, but it's the same anywhere you want to advertise. So what were the key features of Google AdWords you noticed in this video? Like what all functionalities, capabilities Google AdWords give you? One is you can control your budget. Like you can, you know, give a final total budget. You can specify a daily budget as well. So you have a much more flexibility. Yeah. What else did you see? Yeah. So in terms of, say, if you compare with any other form of traditional advertising, you know, you can edit the ad in real time. You want to change the landing page URL, you want to change the keywords for which you want to show an ad, you want to change the ad display. So anywhere, you know, anytime, it's real time. So that flexibility of the message you want to communicate is another big advantage. While in other forms, you know, it will be typically, even in the other forms of traditional banner, you have given to a publisher, you know, you don't have a real time control. Sure, so that's another big advantage. What else? Geo-targeting. If you see location-wise, you know, you can advertise to the people country-wise, city-wise, even to even further extent. You want to say that people around 10 kilometers around Karol Bagh, Khan Market, or any of these places which are part of that, only those people, when they are searching for that keyword, your ad will be shown. So that's another big, big advantage. For a local business which has no interest whether people get to know about that business in other parts of the world, using Google AdWords, you have that flexibility. Only people in this area, when search for that keyword, this ad to be shown. Sure, so that's another big advantage of Google advertising. What else? Time of delivery. You know, you want to specify during these days, this particular duration. Like you feel that your audience is most likely to be receptive to your message on weekends. And also on the weekends, say from 5 to 7 p.m. in the evening, you can do that as well. So that's another reason why Google AdWords picked up. Any other thing you saw? Yeah, of course, you know, that's the biggest advantage. Your ad may be shown to 100,000 people, but if only 10 people click on the ad, you are paying only for those clicks. Right, anything else? So then, of course, so there are a lot of advanced features in terms of you can put, if these keywords are part of the, you know, search queries, then my ad should not be shown. For example, one of the most popular negative keywords people want to use is free. So if you are selling something and you believe that, you know, largely people who are interested in free stuff only, I don't want to display my ad. So you can use free as a negative keyword, which means if someone is searching free XYZ, your ad will not be shown. That's another advantage. Anything else you saw? Any question you may have on this part about the capabilities of Google AdWords? Yeah. No. So this is by, I think, Google AdWords UK only. I have not made any video like this. Any other input? Any other observation from this video? Or you got the context in terms of? So one is, of course, in terms of the model itself. That's a large breakthrough which Google could create. And after that, in going in depth, all of these functionalities and much more I'll be talking about. Right? So can we move forward? Okay, thanks. So other places, you know, other than Google, if you see Yahoo Ads is there. Of course, like Google in the search, the market share it has, similar market share will be by Yahoo and Microsoft. So Yahoo has its own similar PPC model. Bing, Microsoft has its own PPC model. There are a lot of localized search engines, like there are localized social networks, especially in China and other, you know, even a lot of European countries. There are like Baidu in China, and if you see Russia, all of these places have many localized channels. So if your interest is in reaching out to those audience in those countries, rather than, you know, maybe focusing on Google, it may be Baidu may work out even better. And they have a similar model as well. Then there's a concept of ad networks. Do you understand what is an ad network? Okay. Can anyone share what is an ad network? I saw ad network was being talked earlier as well. What is an ad network? Yeah. Right. Sure. So the concept of ad network is, as it says, network. It has an inventory of publishers and advertisers. Largely, it has an inventory of publishers. For example, you want to advertise on auto-related sites in one particular or a specific target audience in particular location. And there are thousands of portals, thousands of publishers. So ad networks, you know, would have, like many of them are focused ad networks. So like there would be ad networks which focuses on these verticals. Means they will have the best inventory of publishers in those verticals. So going through that ad networks gives you that flexibility, gives you that focus, which otherwise may not be possible just by going through, you know, generic search engines. The ad network is essentially an inventory of publishers or a network of publishers and advertisers. Given, you know, they have a controlled inventory, you may be able to target better by going through ad networks. And they have all kinds of models. So if you see even Google, going through Google, there is a concept of cost per acquisition. Like once Google has a history of your conversions, Google gives you that CPA model. Like you pay only when someone, for example, fills a form. So there's a whole concept of CPA, there's a concept of CPL, which is a cost per lead. A lot of ad networks works on the model of CPL or even more performance rather than just click. So going through ad networks gives you a lot of those flexibilities, which otherwise if you directly go to a publisher, you may not get. A lot of publishers don't give any of these models, even CPC, if you go directly to them. But going through ad networks, you may be able to get those functionality on the same publishers. And no, you can do that as well. So I was just coming to that. If you see Google AdWords or Google is largely probably the biggest ad network as well. So through Google, you can advertise on search engine. Through Google, you can advertise on other publishers as well. So advantage of going through Google is one is while on Google search engine, you can only have text ads. Going through Google AdWords, if you want to advertise on publishers, you can do various other kinds of ads. You want to run a banner ad, you can do that through Google AdWords itself. Going through Google AdWords, you can specify only these sites I want to advertise in a CPC model in an image format. So you can run a banner ad on, say, for example, TechCrunch or Mashable. I want to run my ad to be seen by people in India on TechCrunch, and I want to see this banner ad. You can do that through Google AdWords as well. So, you know, typically it depends on the publishers. No, no, but if you see, so the advantage of... Right, sure. So if you see from a publisher point of view, they don't want to play around with the user experience. Right, for them, end of the day, the loyalty of their readers is going to be a function of how well they are able to serve the content which is relevant. A lot of sites, you know, will clutter the whole page with the ads. So while the best publishers will make it as much as contextual and as much as such that it doesn't come in the user experience. See, the advantage in a lot of cases, you will see running an ad through Google, this is called placement targeted or content network, is a banner ad. So text can do a job in terms of when you are running through search engines on directly on search engine. But a lot of times for your business, a banner may speak much, you know, louder than a text ad. So going through Google AdWords for placement targeting in many cases works great. Of course, you know, there would be n number of variables you would want to do the testing, but different people have seen different experiences, and still Google AdWords running, you know, for publishers ads is still another big component. What do you think is a major difference between running an ad on search engine, like, you know, we saw earlier, versus an ad on a publisher site? What is the major difference? Right. So that's the biggest difference. So while if your ad is being shown when someone is searching for a keyword on search engine, that means that person has asked for that information. So for example, when someone searched for flower delivery in Connaught Place, and then that person is saying that I'm looking at maybe vendors like that. While if that person is on a publisher side, which is all about gifting, your banner comes in. No, that person may not be actively looking for that. So that's one big advantage Google search engine, you know, running an ad through Google search engine will have. But at the same time, so it's end of the day, it's not about, you know, finally the number of just impressions. You may definitely, in terms of the number of clicks for the same impressions, will be much lower going through Google content network. But for a lot of businesses, you will see that, you know, probably that is working better because you are able to target the sites. So it has to be, I'm sharing with you all possible scenarios where all you can do that. And there would be enough examples across every vertical, across every category, across these platforms. So, but the whole point is, the whole concept of placement ad networks gives you flexibility, gives you freedom, maybe gives you focus, which otherwise you may not get if you want to reach out to those publishers directly. And Google is one of the biggest ad networks. Is that clear? Does that make sense? Any question about ad networks? Or can I move forward? Okay, thank you. So then publishers, you know, one is you can directly. So if you see, a lot of publishers today themselves have been forced to offer cost per click model. However, largely, unless you are a large advertiser, going through a publisher directly is, in most of the cases, an expensive deal. But if you're a large advertiser, for example, you know, you want to run a Sony, LG, many of them would go to directly publishers because they have a large budget, they can influence, they can take that specific set of audience on specific sections. But as a small advertiser, you may not get that advantage if you are directly approaching to the publishers. But largely, if you see, before PPC, this was largely the model in terms of publishers were offering CPM model. At that point of time, way back in 2000, you know, the whole concept of hits, the term which was, you know, more misused than used, it was about, so what does hit means is, when a page is loaded, every component, which may be image, which may be an applet or any of those, all those were counted as hits. What people will do is, they will make their page such that every loading of a page has 50 hits, and you were charged based on hits. Then came the concept of views. Then came the concept of clicks. And today it's largely about, you know, people want leads and finally even the revenue. So that's how even the whole model progressed. Earlier it was largely publishers, and hits was a currency which was, I would say, more misused .com times. And that was the whole concept of, you know, we will run an ad just by the sake of having a great domain name. You will get funding because you are expected to get that much advertising. Because advertisers were not intelligent. Advertisers were not educated. Today, it's, you know, everyone asks for performance. That has been the shift. Then if you see, you know, some of you have already shared, ads have moved to different formats and ads have moved to different platforms. Like, how many of you know about SlideShare? Most of you, right? You know about SlideShare as a model for advertising? Any one of you have used SlideShare advertising? Or do you know that it has an advertising model? You know, some of you know, right? So even SlideShare has two models, which is, so SlideShare is one of the largest document sharing channels. You have your PPTs, you have your PDFs shared on SlideShare. And they came up with a model called, say your PPT is being shown and someone who's interested wants to reach out to you. At any place in the PPT, you can insert a form. And when someone fills the form, only then you are paying to SlideShare. So that's another cost per lead model. And you pay depending upon when someone fills the form. And depending upon the number of fields you ask in terms of the information, the price goes up. So that's an interesting model. Then SlideShare even has a similar, another concept of sponsored presentation. So you can define that someone who's in this category, he's seeing some other presentations, your presentation can be shown as a sponsored presentation. So that's largely work on the cost per, you know, click model. So there's a whole CPC, CPL model, which is in SlideShare, interesting format, which they came up with recently. Then YouTube has a model. You know, if you search on YouTube, you will see on the top sponsored videos. So that's YouTube promoted videos. Sometime back, Twitter has started to monetize, and there is a concept of sponsored tweets. Anyone of you understand what is a sponsored tweet? How does that work? So if you see Twitter, technically, is the second largest search engine today. It is, you know, Yahoo was second largest, then YouTube became second largest, and today, Twitter is the second largest search engine. Because Twitter is being used for brands to listen to what is being talked about them. How is it a search engine is? You want to find out anyone who has talked about a keyword. For example, ICICI Bank is using Twitter to find out anyone who's tweeting with ICICI as a word. You can do that real time. So that model, given Twitter is being used largely as a listening tool, Twitter came up with the concept of promoted tweet. How does that work is, like on Google, you search on a keyword, your ad is shown. On Twitter, like Starbucks, you know, when someone is searching for Starbucks, on the top, there will be a tweet which will be mentioned, promoted tweet, promoted by Starbucks coffee. So you can specify the keywords which will be used by people who are listening on Twitter and your tweet is at the top. Right now, it's still in beta. Twitter is working with some of the large brands, largely Coke, Disney, Starbucks, Verizon, mostly in US. And so far, whatever I've heard, I have not used at all, is very, very expensive. But that is the way online advertising, or in a similar way, you know, that's how it is moving. And there will be a lot of even more interesting and advanced forms of advertising. Okay, so got it. So I don't think YouTube has a CPL model. SlideShare has. I have used it as well. It was, I think, $2 or $3 a lead. $2-$3 a lead when the form is filled. And at that point of time, I had used it probably around 10 months back. Especially in India, the quality was a big issue because a lot of students were using. So one of the, and I met with the, you know, their team here in India as well. And largely what they saw was a lot of people use SlideShare for research. Like they are looking at presentations. And there's a huge amount of or volume of people who are largely students looking at presentations. So we also saw a lot of forms were largely by students. That was one quality issue. And what they were doing, and I'm sure this would have been much better now, they started doing a lot of filtering. Because if you get 100 leads and largely they are from students, you know, end of the day, it will not be of any use. So they were doing a lot of intelligent as well as manual filtering to avoid those leads. So if you see, you know, even leads may not be sufficient. So even CPL model may not be sufficient. So the more closer you can get to the business goal, you know, the more chances of you being, you know, able to use those that money successfully. But, you know, this is the whole world of digital. If you compare this with any form of other advertising, you don't ask beyond a certain number. I would say today in digital, the concept of measurability is oversold to an extent that largely, you know, if an agency comes to you, you would say, okay, you know, take 10% after you make 100 rupees for me. Its expectation is like, you will give me revenue and you take 10% of that. But I'm saying is still a lot of, you know, going closer towards you meeting your business objective is becoming possible, even in the forms like through a presentation. So that's how it works. It has a $2 or $3. So there is a concept of how much information. For example, you want just an email ID and name, or you want a phone number as well. Or there may be more fields added. So depending upon how much information you want, because as the amount of information increases, the filtration of the quality increases and less people may fill the form. So the cost of that lead also increases. But it was around $2 or $3, and it depends again, you know, location. So I'm talking about India, US maybe $4. Got that? Okay. Any other question on this? So far? Are we on sync? Thanks. So then came up, you know, this LinkedIn ads and Facebook ads. How many of you have used LinkedIn ads? You have used? How has been your experience? Quality of, okay. Okay. And you ran the ad in India? Okay. So if you see, LinkedIn has the LinkedIn advertising model, where again both models are there. CPM, which is, so CPM is, you know, a term which is for impressions. Every 1,000 impressions, whether someone has clicked, whatever happens to the ad, doesn't matter. Every 1,000 impressions, you pay a fixed amount. So that is a CPM model. Similarly, LinkedIn has a CPC model as well. The advantage of LinkedIn is, or for that matter, any network. So what do you think is the biggest advantage of advertising on a social or professional network like this versus Google? Targeting, right? So if you see, when you are on LinkedIn or on Facebook, LinkedIn knows who you are. LinkedIn knows your location. LinkedIn knows your company. LinkedIn knows your interest based on, you know, which groups, the profile, the summary. LinkedIn knows your gender. I think age probably is also there. LinkedIn knows your age. Similarly, Facebook. So compared to Google, the advantage of advertising on networks like Facebook, LinkedIn is network knows who you are. So that means you can do much better targeting than Google. Because on Google, of course, location Google would know based on the IP address. But Google would know your intent based on the keyword you are using. If you are, you know, using keyword like, say, flowers, from that Google will derive that, you know, there is an intent of that kind of information. While network knows who you are. But what's the disadvantage of advertising on, say, Facebook or LinkedIn versus Google? Or what is the advantage of Google? Still, Google has one major advantage. It's push, you know, if you see, yeah, that's again like a placement targeting. When an ad is shown on Facebook or LinkedIn, people have not asked for that information. You are still pushing an ad. Of course, you can do much better targeting because you know who the person is, but you are not giving an ad when someone is asking for that information. So that's way, still I would say, it's not that, you know, Facebook is better than Google, or Google is even better than Facebook. I have seen enough examples where people have seen either of that working or both are working. So both have their advantage. The bigger advantage Google will continue to have is people are asking for the information. While on Facebook, sure. So even on Google, so while that point of time you may want to run more of Google placement targeted. So while your objective is just visibility, like Airtel, for example, when they, you know, did a revamp of their logo, you know, they spent 300 crores. That point of time, the only objective was people should know that Airtel is coming up with a new logo. For them, it didn't matter, you know, are more people buying the, you know, connections or that. So it was pure rebranding exercise. That point of time, they would buy as much as inventory possible. So depending upon your business objective, definitely, you know, you would want to use different networks. But otherwise, if you see, you know, these are the key differences between a search engine versus rest of the publishers. So one is a normal publisher where it's a pure push. It becomes contextual because the ad is shown based on the content. Largely if you see, especially the text ads, while you are reading an article on a publisher, you would see an ad which is related to that. That's how the matching is being done, to make it as much as relevant. While on networks, based on the profile of the person and the interest as well, the ad is, you know, made as much relevant as possible. While on Google, people are asking for it. So that's a big difference. So if you see LinkedIn, do you know what is the cost, minimum cost per click for a LinkedIn ad? Anyone, if you had used, do you remember? The cost per click, the minimum cost per click. Oh, you ran a CPM campaign? Okay. So the cost per click while on Google, do you know what is the cost per click, minimum cost per click on Google? Theoretical? It's 1 cent. The minimum is 1 cent. It's not that you will get clicks at 1 cent. That's a theoretical minimum possible. That means if someone clicks on an ad, least you will have to pay is 1 cent, which is like, you know, 40 paisa. While on LinkedIn, any guesses? What is the minimum cost per click? Any guesses? $1. Okay, you are close. $2. It's $2. Yes, that's a minimum cost per click. So you pay every click $2. Yes, even in India. Yeah. Still, yeah. So what is there is, if you see, if your idea is, you know, branding or even B2C, definitely LinkedIn ads are not for you. But still there are examples like, and even small companies and an IT services company, if your deal size is say $100,000 on average, using LinkedIn ads, you can specify this geography, this industry vertical, and this profile of people. So you want to say US telecom CXO. So given that targeting, given professional, it may still be worthwhile if your deal size is, you know, $100,000, $250,000, like that. And I know there are some examples where someone spent, you know, $50,000 on LinkedIn ads, which means 25,000 clicks, and they made revenue which was, you know, a couple of million dollars or in, of that fraction. So if you want to run a LinkedIn ad in that scenario, it may work. But still, if you want to do it, you should have sufficient budget. So you should not try for, you know, say I will try for $100. Most likely those $100 would be a great experiment for you to learn. Don't expect anything. The advantage is you can target profile. Vertical, profile, geography. Telecom CXOs. That may be worth for a lot of people. Even if one deal gets clicked out of even 1,000 clicks, or maybe 10,000 clicks, still may be worth it. Especially, if, for example, if you have an enterprise product, you know, where every incremental sale is profit. So LinkedIn ads is not that doesn't work, but yeah, majority of cases, B2C, if you have a product or a service which the deal size is small, it is not for you to try. But the advantage is profile, even the designation. And depending upon, again on LinkedIn, you know, how much targeting you want, the cost per click goes up. Right? So far, are we clear on LinkedIn ads? Yeah, so CPM is minimum $1. I think one or one point, it was probably one only. The minimum CPM on LinkedIn is $1. While on rest of that, you know, on Google, you can do as low as, again, a 1 cent. But yeah, doesn't mean you will get at that. But yeah, one, I remember, in India it was $1. Sorry? No. So still if you see, largely, even the click-through rate of a push ad is not even more than 0.1% and above is great. Which means, out of 1,000 impressions, if you are getting more than one click, it is a great CTR. Which, where the average? So that's, say, I don't know in terms of, I don't have any numbers. What I'm saying is minimum is $1. No, could be. $1, you may not get that many even. Yeah. That's average. Okay. $1 is theoretical, like, you know, in terms of minimum you have to bid. Without that, you cannot even run an ad. Like on Google, 1 cent is average. Sorry, minimum cost per click. You cannot run an ad without that. $1 is the CPM on which you will be able to may get some impressions. So the point is, in a CPM model, I'm saying 0.1% and above is a great click-through rate, which means out of 1,000, I would say that is, if you want to see benchmark, it will be largely 0.0%. It will not be even 0.1. Average CPM across publisher network and all of that would be maybe 0.05, maybe even less. So the number of clicks are not so high. That's why even, you know, looks like $1 is a much easier deal or much cost effective deal. Right? So that answers your question? Yeah, so yeah, that's $1 is theoretical. Even if you want to get some clicks, probably it will be, you know, $4, $5, $6. I think it should be less. Maybe recently it might have increased. I remember when we tried some LinkedIn ads, the CPM was not $6. It was, of course, more than $1. $1 is a minimum. Sorry? Oh yeah, so I'm coming to Facebook. So Facebook ads offers a lot of advantage, even other than advertising. I'll do that right now, real time with you. What do you think is the advantage of, or what do you think is the minimum cost per click on Facebook ads? It has both, again, CPC and CPM model. How many of you have run Facebook ads? All of you. Any successes? You found it working? You didn't find it working? You ran the ad for a Facebook page or outside the Facebook? Outside. Okay, outside the Facebook page, right? For leads, maybe. So what is the minimum cost per click on Facebook ads? 2 rupees, okay. Any other number? Theoretical. It's 1 cent again. But you don't get any impression. Say, if you see the model, there is a one part is the minimum theoretical. But what decides that what, how many clicks you will get is a function of competition. There's a whole concept of bidding, right? So what happens is, for example, if someone is searching on a keyword, depending upon how many advertisers are there and whosoever is willing to pay, you know, it decides which ads will be shown at what position. Especially on Google, if you see, there's a whole concept of position, where your ad is being shown. So the model of minimum theoretical is one, which is, you know, you can't get cheaper than that. But what is even more important is the competition. It is a bidding. So what you need to do is, you know, the whosoever has bids the highest, if you can do 1 cent more than that, you will get the, so there is another concept as well, which I'll share later. You will get a position on the top. So 1 cent is the average, minimum cost per click on Facebook. But if you run an ad today on Facebook for 1 cent, there are a few examples, I would say, but in 99.9% cases, you may get few initial impressions, but after that, your ad will not be shown.